Hey, YouTubers! Well, welcome to Gunstar Fighter Update number 11. If you hear any scratching or whatever over here, Ruby is over here preening. It's been pitching a fit today. Anyways, we have a pretty big show. It is a Thursday today, and we're going to show you where we're at. We are a day away from getting out of Butt Ugly stage. Yes, all the parts except those little bumper coil things, those little... Best show you. Because Papa can be awful vague. These guys that were the, still on the flash part, these little protector things that go around the laser turrets are way too wimpy to work with. So I'm going to hop down to the old Ace Hardware store here, where I always find what I'm looking for. And I'm going to get some metal approximately the same diameter. And I'm going to create those parts. And we're going to use that instead. Some news. Matthew Hackley at, I believe, MatthewHackleyBlogspot.com or something along that line. CardinalSinsBlogspot.com is his website. Does wonderful figures. Got back to me why he hasn't, you know, been in touch with me about the figures he's doing. The main character and old turtle head back there. And reason is he's been ill. But he did get back and he said, yeah, I'm on it. I'll have him by the end of the week. I just got back to him and said, well, I don't need him for a couple weeks, Matt. So, you know, chill out. It's okay. But figures still go. Get very accurate figures for the ship, which I'm really wanting. Right now, she is completely together. Again, short of those little wire detail thingies. Everything is together. Yes, Ruby. The canopy right now is being redone crystal clear by my good friend Elliot Brown over at Fedoratron, I believe. I can never say it, but you can probably see it right here, right now. Do visit the site. Elliot offers wonderful services, makes awesome parts. He's just, you know, fantastic. God, I wish he made decals. I really do, Elliot. I wish he made decals. But for parts and all that, awesome. I could not have done the Giant DeBoer's Enterprise refit kit as well as I did without Elliot's help. He made this brass set that is probably going to be standard issue. Oh, hello, Ruby. Boy, you still can hop, can't you? We may have to interrupt the film if he gets too nutty here and starts chewing on my sunglasses. What else? Oh, so I'll show you. We finally got all the auxiliary laser turrets done. There was four in the front, and there was two in the back. And I kind of saved that for last because that required all the wires being tucked a certain way. Now we are going to, I'll show you. We got the masks in from Lou Damaso at AztecDummy.net, who also, got to give everybody their kudos, who also provided specialty cut mask. Now, let's see what else. I'm doing this on the fly. It's in the afternoon. It's hot in here. I got to turn on the AC soon, so this intro won't be that long. Bear with me. Let's see. So what I'm going to do, we're going to flip over to the table, show you what's been done. I'm going to give you a glimpse at some of these masking sheets that I'm going to do next. I got two diameters, and I'll show you why I got those two diameters. And then next week, you'll be able to see pretty much everything primed, the stage of it primed, and if I have enough time by next week, you'll start to see the first metal plating going down. Like I said, the canopy's not here right now. The chairs, I may show you while we're over there, that, you know, are sitting aside waiting to be fiber optic and all that. But I can't do that till I've got everything going. I took off the mask over the canopy section now because I've gotten all the messy work out of the way. I'm going to have to reapply a fresh one before I start doing the primer stuff. You'll see also some access holes that were cut into the body that were required when we were doing some of the final tweaking, get some of the wires in this thing, because this thing, you know, was like eight great big chunks, and as I'm going along, I knew I was going to have to cut some holes in there, and Scott did too, my client, to light it up, because this thing I don't think was designed to be lit up, or whoever built it knew that if you were going to light it up, it was going to be Swiss cheese. So that's the way it went. And today, unless this film drags on forever, and I'm still waiting for costume parts for it. Anyways, A new character unveils. Now, none of the other characters, as far as we know, are completely dead yet. Trek Nazi's kind of cheesy. But you may see him again. He's just kind of moldy. The Professor, well, we're not sure about the Professor. He's been very, very bad. And it took a plastic explosive rendition of a baby Smurf to take him out in his mega tank. Although I did enjoy that video. That was fun. That laser, that was kind of cool. So nobody's out technically. And I did hear somebody in the back row going, "More Vinny!" So you may see Vinny again. And I like Vinny. I think Vinny's funny. So anyways, although a few people said, "I don't like your funnies, but I like the modeling part." Well, don't watch the funnies. You know, don't watch the funnies. Just watch the modeling part and go somewhere else. Okay? Cool. Anyway, so I guess that takes care of it. So, you know, at some point we'll introduce the new character. It is a feed coming in from, like, very, very far away. I don't know who the narrator is, but it's an introduction to this character. Whether the character ends up here or is just constantly being filmed from this location, we don't know yet. We just don't know. We don't know much. So anyways, let's move on. Okay, before we go to the workbench, a few people asked me, and one in particular said, it would be nice if we knew what kit it was. Well, I did mention it, and it is it's a garage kit, and not a lot is known about it. I did mention it's sold at Monsters in Motion. It is called the Ultimate Gunstar Kit. Gunstar Ultimate Resonant Kit from The Last Starfighter. It goes for, $174.99. There it is right here on Monsters in Motion. Catalog number 18SMM03. I'm not sure who's the maker. But that is the kit right there. It's 14 inches, 1/48 scale. So if anybody actually wants to buy the kit and give it a shot, there it is. But as far as a maker or anything like that, Monsters in Motion does not mention the makers. It could be an in-house piece or something they have cast and they bring in or sell through their site. Whoever the maker is, if you want to be known, let me know and I'll mention you in one of the videos coming up, because we've only got a few left on this thing. It will be built in the next 3 or 4 videos and we'll be moving on to our Millennium Falcon project. But there it is for the fellow who was saying it would be nice if we knew what kit it was. Well, that's the kit, okay? So now let's move on to the bench. Okay, so here's our first take at the work table. I'm going to change view here so I can get a look at what's been done that's lit. First off, I want to show you these lovely masks that Lou sent me. There's the 7/16 and the 3/16, and I'll show you why I had two sizes done. There's actually a smaller size, too, that I'm going to use that I already have in stock from Lou to do these tiny little jets here. Now, the first time when I actually do the priming and everything is recovered back here, I've already got the cannons here masked inside the barrels. And let me move in a little bit on that. Let's see here. Gosh, you're slow. But steady. Okay. When we do the first pass, since I'm going to want to do the insides of these thrusters, and let's see, maybe over here is a little better. Yes. In a silver. Well, first off, when we're doing the primer bit, I'm going to cover up these guys here. Since I'm going to do it anyways, I'm going to go ahead and do one right now. Cover up the lighting part here with this smaller one. So then we're going to go back in and do the silvering. That's going to be the first thing I'm going to do, and then do a reprime after doing all the fixing. So once this is covered up here, we're going to be able to use these larger ones to cover up the outside rim here and keep this, once I've silvered it, silver. That's why I've got the two. So anyways, moving on from there. Now we're going to shift positions and I'm going to show you the lighted gun turrets that have been installed. Moving on. Alright, so here's our girl. Although this one looks more like a boy. Big and bulky. Oh, this was quite elegant flying. So here's what we've done now. We've attached all four of those laser turrets right here, like the professor. Everything is ready to go. The only thing that's not on there right now is the canopy. And of course, the chairs are not in place, except I've uncovered the cockpit. All those things will be added on towards the end. Detail effects. Here, of course, is our friendly little pilot's chair, which unfortunately will not pivot much, if at all, guys, because of all the fiber optic work that's going to be added to that. And of course, it is not all silver. It has some beige tones, as you know, as I've showed you prior. This guy needs to be chiseled out a bit more to actually fit in there. The false floor will be fitted. There's lighting going in there, too. Here's one of the sockets on there that will give it an attack angle. That's already been worked out. And that's it. Other than these flash parts, like I've showed you, I'm going to do in metal. She is complete. Let me change angle here for you. And there you go. As you can see, all four. Hold it from over here. And the screen gets a lot luster here. There we go. All four of these four turrets have been done. Let me see if we come up out here a little bit. Bammer. Woo, there you go. Yes, yes. And there you go on those. Also notice these oddball rear struts. Of course, this was CG, and of course, everything is very cubic. These guys here were added on, and I'm still in the process of smoothing them down. After the first primer stage, I'll be able to tell just how much more I need to smooth them down. That's a great thing about gray primer, to let you know if you've still got a ways to go on that. It's very revealing that way. And there's the rear gun turrets. Of course, all this stuff will be pulsing. I like a pulsing look for the guns. Like they're activated, ready to go. You've already seen the thrusters go. Right now, not all the lighting's going, because you remember, it has to go through the board. You can see where I've had to access some of the wiring up here, because it's gotten to be quite a cluster up there. And yeah, you can see right here where I've showed you that one mask for Lou. The bigger one will go over the top once I've silvered the inside. And that's about where we're at, kids. It is fully assembled. Let's get the little chair out of there. It's quite snugly in there. And these guns have already been masked. Put a little piece of Tamiya in there. And she is almost ready to go. Now, once I get it all done, as far as all the detailing and all that, I will attack the cockpit, attach the canopy and all that, and she'll go on her pretty, pretty little stand, and she'll be ready to go. And then, Scott, you can add that to your collection. And she's also quite heavy. And the density of thickness in the walls, of course, wasn't even being a garage kit and probably poured. I ran into walls that were much thicker in the same areas on, left and right side, starboard and port, due to the fact that it is a garage kit. And still a lot of unevenness here and there. Takes a lot of time to get things just right. Some things were, oddball here and there. But overall, I've had a lot of fun with this kit. This has not been an unpleasant kit to build. It's been rather a lot of fun. And I'm hoping to get, here's a rear view for you. I'm hoping to get some stunning results out of it. I've seen some people do quite a good job on this one. But of course, my version hopefully will be different than all their versions was. Like to be unique. And now, we will introduce our new character coming from a land very far away. And only your comments will reveal whether this character is a keeper or whether this character gets snowed under, if you'll pardon the pun, and you'll see why I said that. And I hope you enjoy this new character. It was a little strange. And we'll see you next week with Gather Update number 12, where hopefully we'll be past this very ugly stage. And we'll start seeing some pretty stuff. So y'all have a great weekend. Papa Smurf out.
Here in the Himalayan mountains, strange creatures call it their home. The local Sherpas call them Yeti. For here, he finds his way around his daily life. He's a solitary creature, misunderstood. He is often seen walking against the mountain background. He has been a creature of mystery for decades upon decades. Misunderstood. Often he is seen eating berries, small creatures, and the occasional photographer who happens to get too close. Not a friendly creature, but occasionally funny. He gets very upset when he's out of power. He has no real political stance, but really thinks the Fed should be audited and quickly. Three days ago, a tour bus went through this area, and everyone ended up missing. Mr. Yeti, do you have any idea what happened to those people? Often you can see the Yeti enjoying the woods in sunshine. God knows what stalking was dabbling. The Yeti often resents when somebody questions whether he's real or not. You can tell from his expression. And another day closes here in the Himalayas. God knows what he'll be up to tonight.
All right, kids, as a bonus attraction right here at the end of our little film, I hope you enjoyed our new characters, Little Antics. Here are some pieces that just came in moments ago. This is the internal armature for that huge 6-foot span Klingon bird of prey. And what a shame that no one will ever see these fantastic Klingon lettering etchings. Obviously, the wings, fuselage, center body, actually main body, and I'm thinking somewhere along the line something like this for the neck to main body section. Absolute stunning work, metal work. Ooh, and is it heavy? I'm thinking some kind of manufactured aluminum. This feels more like iron, but no, it is aluminum. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Heck, these things would be gorgeous hanging up on the wall. So a little bonus shot there, guys. The start of the Klingon Bird of Prey, the massive studio scale shipments have started to come in. And I'm sure Jilin is probably quite stunned to see the first of this stuff. The heavy metal has started to roll in, kids. So, just something interesting to end the film with. And just to give you an idea of scale, come here. Come here a second. Come here, don't be shy. Just don't step on the leg. Avoid hitting the leg. Come here. I know. You're looking at the thing. Come here. I want you to get. Come here a second, just to give it the idea. Okay, there you go. Here's my grandson, Ethan. Come here. Oh, he's so shy. Don't get hurt. There he is. Hello, my name is Ethan. Just give me an idea of scale of this thing. Buddy, he is not feeling good. He's got a cough. So that was my grandson, Ethan, making his movie debut. Anyways, just to give you an idea of scale of this thing. Anyways, see you next movie. Papa out.